you with Simply Simple Stamping. Oh, have I got some cards for you today. Check this out. Whoa! 8 super flashcards. I did these so fast. They are so much fun. And you know, look at this, 8 cards. I did it in no time at all. I'm gonna teach you the little secret on how to create these fabulous cards. Let's get going. So to create our super flashcards, I'm gonna be using 2 stamp sets today. I'm gonna start with the first one, that is Garden in Bloom, a absolutely beautiful watercolor stamp set. I am not a watercolor artist, and I am so glad that Stampin' Up! Makes me look like I do. This is a wonderful set with lots of flowers, butterflies, bumblebees, the leaves, everything you need. Really great set, and it's gonna give us a great look on our super flashcards. And then as far as the sentiments, I know that you guys have a lot of sentiments. Feel free to use what you have. I decided to go ahead and use the watercolor words because I just like that watercolor look and I can't get enough of it. So we're gonna be using that for our sentiments. I'm going to begin with a piece of Whisper White cardstock for, this is an 8.5 by 11 sheet, and then we're gonna be cutting it down. Now I'm gonna be doing Pool Party in Basic Black for my cards today. So I've got a Pool Party ink pad, and then I have the large flower from the Garden in Bloom. What we're going to do is super simple. We are just going to stamp randomly all over this cardstock. I want you to keep the flowers very tight. If you spread them out too much, you're not going to like the final project because we're going to be working with it in little strips. So we do want to keep those flowers very tight. Here's what it looks like when it's all stamped. I'm going to go ahead and move my stamp out of the way so I can bring in my next one, which is the outline, and I'm going to stamp that in the Tuxedo Black Memento pad. So to do this, guys, again, very, very simple. I'll ink up my stamp, and then you will just come along and go over it. Now, with the photopolymer, it's just very easy to see right through it. Now, I stamped very randomly and turned my stamp around a lot, so I've kind of found a visual for myself, and that is there is a big fat petal. That's the one I kind of use as my focal, and then that allows me to come in. Whoops. I missed it right there. I'm trying to talk and stamp at the same time, not always a gift. Now you can see this one I got dead on, but this one is off center. It's okay. It doesn't matter. It just really, whatever you do, it's all good for that watercolor look. So we're gonna go and we're gonna do that. We're gonna repeat that all over the cardstock. All right, there it is, all done. It's all stamped, looks awesome. Now, I thought it needed a little something. Don't ask me why, I'm gonna bring in some speckle. And I didn't mention this stamp set when I started the video, but this is from Gorgeous Grunge. It's just one of my favorite little background stamps. So you can see I'm just inking it up, I'm stamping very lightly, and I'm just gonna add some speckle here. Again, the lighter the touch, the better. Do not go and press it really hard. Very, very light, and you're gonna get this gorgeous speckle. So now that we have that all done, let's go ahead. I'm gonna share with you how to cut your cardstock down. I'm going to bring in my Stampin' Trimmer, and so what we're going to do with this piece of cardstock is we're gonna begin by cutting down the 8.5 inch side, and we're gonna cut that down to 4 inches. You're gonna repeat that on both sides so that we have a 4-inch piece of cardstock. We're now going to take that one of the pieces, I should say, one of our 4-inch pieces of cardstock, and we're going to cut that down to 2.5 inches. Each of these down to 2.5 inches. So we'll get 4 of these. I'm going to take my remaining piece and I'm going to cut it down to 2 inches. So I'm going to get a 2-inch. And then we're going to cut this one down. Are you ready? 5 3/8. So you can see there's my 5, just go over 3 notches, 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to have those pieces. We're gonna get 4 of those as well. While we've got the Stampin' Trimmer out, let's go ahead and cut our 8.5 by 11 piece of basic black. These measurements are a tiny bit different. We're going to cut it in half at 4 1/4 inch, set one piece aside. This piece here, we're going to cut 4 equal pieces at 2 3/4 inches. We'll have 4 of these pieces when we're all done. We'll take our remaining piece and we're gonna cut it down to 2 1/8 inch. So that's basically cutting it in half. We're now going to take these pieces and cut those in half. At 5.5, we'll end up with 4 equal pieces here as well. All right, so there's our 8 pieces for our super flash card. Now I'm gonna come in with a petite petals punch, And what I want to do is just punch one flower anywhere out of it. And we're going to do the same thing here with all of the longer pieces. So you can see I have cut a little flower out of all of those. I now want to give these flowers a little dimension. I'm going to use my stylus tool, and you can see I've just given those a press. You just press right there in the center of the flower, and it gives really a really good pop. And if you don't have a stylus tool, the back of a pen, anything will work. But we want to give all those flowers a nice little punch. Let me set those off to the side because we're going to go ahead and start to put our cards together. Now, I'm not going to cut this for you, but basically I had 4 sheets of Pool Party cardstock. I scored them all in half at 4 1/4 and then cut them to 5 1/2. So I have 8 cards. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take one of my pieces of basic black. I'm going to now just adhere stamped image, the stamp piece on there. So I have snail on the back of my focal images here. I'm going to adhere one there. And I'm going to go ahead and put the other one on the exact same way. Or, you know what, just for fun, let's go ahead and just put it on the opposite side. So I have one where it's going to be on this side where the card opens, and one this way. But you can see these cards can go a lot of different ways. That's what's wonderful about this idea. Now, you're going to repeat that with the other 2 cards. Now let me come in and work with my pieces here. Again, I'm just going to do 2 of them for you. Okay, so just as we did before, we are going to put, I'm going to bring it over here so that I can shake things up. As I said, we're going to use the watercolor words as all of our sentiments. Again, you could leave these blank and stamp when you're ready, but I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start with one of these. Let me go ahead and bring in my other 2 cards. This will give me the opportunity to kind of decide how I want these to go. So let's see. I think I'll do hope. I'm going to do it on this long one here. I kind of like how that looks. Gorgeous. Again, I'm not going to go ahead and stamp them all, but you can kind of see we're going to come in with all of those words. Hope, love, you're the best. So for instance, on Just For You, I could put that right there. And so really, you just have a lot of opportunity to just kind of play with the stamps themselves. Now, what to do with those flowers? Let's go ahead and bring in these flowers. I'm going to take a mini glue dot and press the flower down onto the glue dot. And that's just going to give me the opportunity to fill in any way I want. To make them even more stunning, we're just simply going to come in with rhinestones. I'm going to use the medium-sized rhinestones. Love to use my paper piercer to pick up my rhinestones because it allows me to set it right where I want it. Of course, that flower gets great poppage there. So let's go ahead and do our Just For You as well. I'm telling you, it really is that easy. Talk about super flashcards. What a great way to get a lot of different designs, but to be able to do it all so quickly. As I said before, you could leave the sentiments off and add them as you need them. I also wanted to point out a couple of the cards that I created. I decided to go a little crazy. I punched out a couple extra flowers here for the love card. Here on the You're the Best, I decided to add 2 flowers instead of the 1. So feel free to cut out a few extras just so you have the ability to play.
Yeah, I wasn't kidding. That is some serious super flash cards. Guys, I have to be honest, I probably made these in, oh, I don't know, a half an hour tops. It really is a very fast technique. I absolutely love it. Now listen, these are brand new stamp sets to Stampin' Up. These just came out in June 2015. You really must add these to your list. Let's see, what did I use? Watercolor Words. That's where I use the Fabulous Sentiment. And then Garden in Bloom. Oh, watercolor artist without the talent. Woo! I love that because I don't have that kind of talent. So guys, be sure to check that out at simplysimplestamping.com. Now I will have all the pictures of all the cards. I'm going to have them all there for you on the website. Just be sure to check it out. I'll have all the information right there also in the YouTube description. So be sure to look at it. Guys, thanks so much for being here and being a part of Super Flash Cards. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.